Back in 1968, Israel and Iran were friends, and they had a grand plan, the Trans-Israel Pipeline. This was when the Shah of Iran ruled, but when that changed in 1979, Iran turned hostile towards Israel, and the Islamist regime of Iran dropped a mega opportunity to bring in riches into the country. But as they say, one man's loss is another man's gain. And in this case, the UAE jumped in. The Trans-Israel Pipeline now binds the UAE and Israel together. The pipeline itself is a game changer in the Middle East, and it is all set to start its course. So while Iran lost everything, the UAE seized the perfect opportunity, and Israel emerged as the biggest winner. Hi, and welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host Shubhangi, and in this video, I will tell you about the Trans-Israel Pipeline and the geopolitical equations tied around it. The Abraham Accord between Israel and the United Arab Emirates is opening up a new era in the Middle East. It is going to revolutionize energy trade in the region by reinvigorating the Trans-Israel Pipeline, which will assure smooth trade of Gulf oil into the Mediterranean and further north into European markets. The Trans-Israel Pipeline connects Eilat, located on the Gulf of Aqaba, at the northern tip of the Red Sea, to Ashkelon, an Israeli port city on the eastern Mediterranean coast. The 254-kilometer-long pipeline passes through the Negev Desert region and effectively bypasses the Suez Canal. The pipeline actually has a very interesting history. It was built in 1968 as a part of an agreement between Israel and Iran. Tehran used to be represented by the moderate Shah regime those days, and Israel and Iran used to be allies. The two countries had then constructed the strategic pipeline to transport Iranian crude oil to customers in Israel and Europe. The Trans-Israel Pipeline became a lifeline for the Iranian oil trade when Egypt closed the Suez Canal in 1967. But the 1979 Islamic Revolution toppled the Shah of Iran, and consequently, the Trans-Israel Pipeline fell into disuse. Now, the Trans-Israel Pipeline project seems bound to resurrect as a great product of the Abraham Accord. Emirati and Israeli energy firms are pushing strongly to make this strategic asset a new symbol of cooperation and kickstart a new export route from the Gulf to Europe. The Trans-Israel Pipeline is, in fact, intimately tied to all the peace efforts in the region. In fact, soon after the UAE and Israel signed the Abraham Accord last year, a further deal was struck between owners of the said pipeline, the EAPC, and an Israeli-UAE joint venture called the MEDRED Land Bridge. An EPAC statement in October 2020 revealed that under the said deal, the UAE will supply tens of millions of tons per year to the Trans-Israel Pipeline. What the pipeline does is that it ensures that Israel has a central role to play in energy trade from the Gulf to Europe. And this is really a significant development given Israel's size as a country. The resurrection of the Trans-Israel Pipeline ensures that the Jewish nation serves as a transportation link between Europe and the Gulf. Also, it was reported in December last year that former US President Donald Trump was pushing other Arab nations like Oman, Sudan, Morocco, Saudi Arabia, and Jordan to partner with Israel in order to expand the Trans-Israel Pipeline. Given the narrow passage of the Suez Canal route and the recent incident of a container ship blocking the canal in May, other Arab nations would, in fact, be tempted to get involved in the Trans-Israel Pipeline. The other thing is that Israel is also working on the EastMed Pipeline, which will connect Leviathan gas field in Israel and the Aphrodite gas field in Cyprus to Greece before entering the European markets. The project excludes a belligerent Turkey from cooperation in energy trade via the Eastern Mediterranean. The Trans-Israel Pipeline will also ensure that the Jewish nation gets primacy in transporting Gulf oil while Turkey remains isolated. Once the oil transported by the UAE and possibly even other Gulf countries reaches Ashkelon in Israel, it can be easily shipped into Europe via the Mediterranean Sea, or a linkage can also be drawn with the East Med pipeline after shipping the Arab oil to either Cyprus or Greece. In any case, the UAE and Israel will be able to manage complete autonomy over oil trade through the Gulf and the Eastern Mediterranean and into Europe. And the biggest losers here are Turkey and Iran.